Cities are part of what makes America beautiful. They also contain all the life and vigor of this dynamic 20th century. They provide architectural beauty, create wealth, boost cultural horizons, and bring people close together so they can exchange goods and services and ideas conveniently. Witness Oklahoma City, capital of a state, home for a 500,000 people and barely 75 years old. Oklahoma City has a proud heritage in art and music. It is the financial headquarters for the state. Its vital economy includes growing industry, fine residential sections. It also contains the scenes you are looking at. These are the scenes of a disease called blight, which, like a deadly mold, has settled on our downtown and is killing it. The symptoms are obsolete structures, congested traffic, too little parking, worn-out hotels and low-grade businesses. Since fewer people come here anymore and business costs are up, many merchants have thrown up their hands in disgust and moved out. But Oklahoma City's downtown is the city's heart. When it stops beating, the whole city will suffer. As a slum, it provides a shabby front parlor to visitors, and they're likely to go to other cities to shop or seek entertainment. Without a downtown, there would be 30,000 fewer jobs in Oklahoma City. Taxes from large downtown buildings amounting to over $2 million would dry up, putting an extra tax burden on homeowners. Conventions, which now bring over $14 million to the city's economy every year, would go elsewhere. Yes, a healthy downtown is vital to Oklahoma City. Our city's vitality depends upon eliminating the present malignant tumor now existing in downtown before it spreads. This tumor can be removed through a dramatic renewal plan which is designed to guarantee downtown rebirth and at the same time provide opportunities for a better life for every Oklahoma City resident. Let's move ahead 10 years from today and see what the planned revitalized Oklahoma City will be like. During this visit, you will notice a rather coarse, grainy quality to the film. This is due to the unusual lens requirements necessary to capture our city of the future on film. For we are making our visit via an exciting new periscopic camera trip. We are riding our camera into and over the streets and parks, the business core and cultural center, new buildings, restored buildings, and treasured landmarks. We'll ride our camera into a dream. A dream that will soon move from the drawing boards and planning sessions and emerge as the second great era of Oklahoma City. This will be a city designed to never grow old. It will have the elements of greatness and be soundly planned to serve you. Below us now is the new $15 million convention center, which will attract over 150,000 conventioneers in this year of 1975, each of whom will spend over $100 in our restaurants, hotels, and stores. Added to other fees and expenses, convention business will add nearly $30 million to our local economy. To orient ourselves, let's look at the view from the front of the convention center today. Tomorrow, this center will face a tree-filled Broadway lined with hotels and convenient parking garages to serve visitors of all types. Such low-traffic streets will be scattered throughout downtown to aid pedestrian circulation. We are now moving on to Main Street and turning east toward the Santa Fe overpass. On the left is an exciting 40-story office tower, located conveniently near hotels for visiting businessmen. This tower is an example of the increased tax yield all citizens will benefit from in a renewed downtown. It will add at least $270,000 in tax revenues each year. On our right is the enlarged Skirvin Hotel, which will have convention facilities of its own. This brings us to Park Avenue, looking west. Today, it is simply a narrow canyon between tall buildings. But tomorrow, a canyon containing a true park area with trees and benches, sidewalk cafes and flower stalls. All the elements of excitement which will help make downtown Oklahoma City as alluring to citizens and visitors as New Orleans' French Quarter, San Francisco's Golden Hills, or San Antonio's Winding River. At the end of this beautiful sweep, a plaza dominated by a huge fountain will be surrounded by city and county offices. The effect will give Oklahoma City an interesting Mediterranean flavor, which matches our mild climate. Today, one of the nooses strangling downtown is traffic congestion. Too much traffic flows through that isn't bound for downtown. Humps like this one at the corner of Sheridan and Robinson tend to slow cars and trucks. The city is now planning and building expressways which will whisk traffic in a loop around downtown and leave these streets for people who want to visit it for fun or for business. Thus, on the Robinson of the future, traffic will flow easier. There will be consideration for the pedestrian, and it will be easier to find and board buses, to find a parking stall, to drive home once our business is finished for the day. Because Oklahoma City residents own more cars per capita than people in Los Angeles, traffic planning is on the top of the priority list for planners of tomorrow's downtown. We are now moving north on Robinson, past the post office building on the left and the city library on the right. And ahead, we are approaching 4th Street and a bright new Federal Plaza. This plaza, combined with such elements as the 40-story office tower, the municipal offices complex, and other new offices, will raise the number of jobs in downtown from 30,000 to 50,000, a factor in itself that will create demand for more downtown housing and better shopping facilities. And as we head down tomorrow's Harvey Avenue, we are approaching a super shopping area. The hot and crowded area we know today will be transformed into an exciting air-conditioned center for specialty shops not found elsewhere in Oklahoma. The boundless markets of the world will provide an allure for shoppers living throughout the region that surrounds us. Prestige department stores will serve the entire city, not just a single neighborhood. Parking will be quick and easy, with stalls built into the center atop each store the customer wishes to visit, and with escalators located nearby to whisk him to lower levels. At the end of this area, aside from the expanding Sheraton Hotel, today there's a jumble of old buildings providing obsolete facilities for individuals struggling to make use of them. It is a jumble which would best be transformed to provide a park area. It may take the form of the famous Tivoli Gardens in Copenhagen, a center of recreation and adventure, full of restaurants, amusement facilities, and bordered by nightclubs. Nearby will be the new Mummers Theater. Tivoli will also provide recreation for about 4,000 families who will choose to live downtown close to the excitement and to work. They'll mostly live in this area north of Robert S. Kerr Avenue, on the street we are now traveling west. This section is now crowded with low-grade residential and business establishments. Tomorrow, this area will have apartments in an open space environment. Living here will be young adults who like to be where the action is, retired couples who prefer the bustle of the city's heart, people who like to be near their work, and others. These townhouses and high-rise apartments will be needed to meet a growing trend in Oklahoma City residents to prefer apartment living. And as you can see, These will be apartments like no others in the state. They'll have an exciting metropolitan flavor, but they'll still retain the broad open spaces so dear to the hearts of Oklahomans. Here on today's Walker Avenue, you see people and cars and life. In the scenes you've viewed of tomorrow's city, there is something missing. People. The people will be you and the person sitting around you. For tomorrow's city is being designed for you. It is being designed to give you a city which will be acclaimed around the world as a wonderful place to live. A sense of being part of a community will again be possible. A renewed downtown will tie the sprawling sections of Oklahoma City together once more by providing a central core of fun and excitement. Crowded conditions and unsightly downtown scenes will be eliminated. The opportunities for a better job and a better standard of living will increase for each of us simply because the heart of the city will beat faster, pumping even greater vitality into every area. At the present time, this other city is half dream and half reality. It can spring to life in well-planned stages over the next 10 years if Oklahoma City can capture the imagination needed to make dreams come true. Other cities have experienced the same problems with their downtowns, and they've solved them. European capitals have set centuries-old traditions of keeping their downtown centers beautiful, alive, and productive. And in company with such traditions, surely Oklahoma City's 75-year-old downtown is too young to die. If you agree, let your feelings be known. If you want more information, called the Urban Renewal Authority. The initial planning is in. The rest is up to you.